Citlali, and I am excited to talk about my experience at East Los Angeles College, located in Monterey Park, California. It's been a lot of years now that I graduated from ELAC. I attended ELAC late 2000 to class of 2013. Then I went on with math, which was my biggest weakness, and I was able to finally start at Cal State LA 2015 and graduate with summa cum laude in 2016. So that's a whole other video. But for now, I love East LA College, and every time I go there to speak to students, I do public speaking, I do motivational talks, I do workshops. It always takes me back to that feeling I had when I was there at East LA College, early 2000s. And I wanted to make a video because I want people to see themselves in me, especially if you're a first generation college student. I want you to know the resources. I want you to know the capabilities that you have, the resources, the amount of support that you're gonna get because I obtained it. What I wanted to talk about was, first of all, I did not see myself going to college at all. Even though I started really wrong in high school, I would skip class. I was, you know, trying to be against the system, but I didn't understand how I was being counterproductive, because even though I would criticize history courses, you know, my history teacher, you know, how can I be taken seriously if I'm skipping class? Or how can I be taken seriously if I'm not putting in the work, right? So it was in the last semester of the ninth grade, where the second semester of the ninth grade, where I started learning about my history, started learning about my true identity. I started learning about the negated knowledge, right, of our history as Mexican, Central American people, Native American people. And I really started developing a very, very strong interest in history and how are things constructed, how are things developed, right? Especially identity. I started understanding that I wasn't Hispanic or Latina. I started understanding that the process that we come through as Mexicans, it's a very traumatic one that was in the process of genocide. But even more important, I started understanding the ancient civilizations that I come from and my people come from. And so politically, things started making sense to me, right, at such a young age. But unfortunately, I didn't have enough credits to graduate with my graduating class. So in the year 2000, even though I did get scholarships, unfortunately, I wasn't able to graduate with my class, but I did attend adult school. Attending adult school was a whole other system for me, because I had to leave my house when I was very young, at about 18, 19. I had to leave my household. It wasn't the best place for me to be. So I had to leave. I had to work. I was working 2-3 jobs on the weekend. But luckily, my soccer coach in high school, in Huntington Park High School, she had pushed us to play soccer at East LA College. She had told us, you know, like, go to college. You don't have to figure it out right now, but just go. You have to go. And even though I didn't have my high school diploma, back then you could take a test and be accepted and be qualified for financial aid. So then I went that route and I played soccer at East LA College. And even though I was going through a lot of stuff in my life, having that support and having that introduction to college and being with my friends and playing soccer and going to school full time and getting all these resources, it was really life-changing, because at that time, like I said, I was struggling. I was living on my own. I was, it came to a point where I was sleeping in my car. So I went through this process of working, going to adult school, playing college soccer. And, you know, there was a lot of things happening. I needed a lot of help, and I wasn't sure how to express it, how to say it. But luckily, the Dean of Student Services at that time, Mr. Oscar Valeriano Jr., amazing individual, amazing man. He was actually part of East LA College in the 60s and 70s. He was actually part of the historical student movements that were there. And that actually before Mecha, he was one of the leading voices that were talking about equity and about inclusion and about making education accessible to all of our people. Anyway, that would be another video. he really took interest in students, not just in, you being successful and getting here and getting out, but he made sure that we as individual students, that our needs were looked at, right? And when I met him, I was going through a lot of things. I suffered from depression, anxiety. I was overcoming a lot of trauma in my life. And he actually, you know, sat me down and he walked me over to the counseling office. And for those of you who don't know, as students, you do have free access to counseling on site. So I remember going to the counselor at that time at Iseli College, and she really changed my life. Like I said, I was in the point where I was very depressed. I was going through a lot. I was going through suicidal, you know, thoughts. There was so much trauma that I was trying to deal with. Plus, I was an activist. Plus, you know, I'm doing public speaking. Plus, I don't know how to deal with my living situation. But being there at ELAC and being given that resource of counseling and also student work, I was able to work. I was working at Rivera Street. And also, Oscar Valeriano was able to connect me with a job at the financial aid office as a student worker. So, mind you, I'm getting counseling, I'm working on campus, I'm working on the weekends, I was working at City Terrace Library, but all of these resources, right, began to work in my favor, right? The counseling that I went to was very powerful. I would say it changed and saved my life attending Iseli College at that time. Receiving financial aid, receiving counseling, receiving support, having these jobs. And at that point, I didn't think highly of myself. I knew I was smart, but I had messed up in high school, so I figured out I probably can't do much here. But attending Iseli College, and believe me, I was working full-time, so my history at Iseli College, you know, if you look at my enrollment, it's very zigzagged, right? I would take a class here, I would take two classes there, I would take a class online. But the thing is that being there and being exposed to the services and the quality care that I was given and meeting amazing people that to this day, I've met my best friends there. I've met people that to this day are part of my support system, part of my circle, and who I consider family now. Being there, being surrounded by that atmosphere, by those resources, really changed the way that I viewed myself and viewed my future. Like I said, I didn't imagine myself going to college. It wasn't in the books for me. I was first generation. No one in my family could support me and could understand the struggle that I was going through, not just, you know, going being first generation college student, but the traumas I was battling with, right? And so going to Iseli College, I first majored in like anthropology, then journalism, then I landed in history. And at that time, from 2001 to around 2013, like I said, I would go to college, you know, and then I had to go to work. So I couldn't really have a steady presence in school, but I was there. And every time I was there, the people I met, the support that I received was immense, was transformative, was powerful. And that is why when I finished in 2013, I was class of 2013, I was super excited. I threw myself for my level, the biggest party I can throw, right? Because I obtained my associates. I threw myself, I had a taco man, I had DJ, I had a bouncer. It just felt surreal that I could accomplish something without the much needed support that I felt like I lacked. And then to actually believe in myself and to actually apply to like UCLA, I applied to different programs and I was accepted to UCLA and I did go to the summer program, but unfortunately it didn't work with my schedule. Like, again, I am a working student. Work is my priority, right? I am self-sustaining. I am an independent student. And so, but being able to be accepted to UCLA and taking those courses, and even though I didn't go to UCLA, I ended up going to Cal State LA. Once I transferred to Cal State LA, my job, they had closed down. I was working for a for-profit college, when that job closed down, my partner was like, focus on school, get it done, get it done. And I did. I went to Cal State LA spring 2015. I finished within a year and one semester. I got my bachelor's in history with summa cum laude, which is the highest honors. I then went on directly, continued on, and obtained my master's in history from Cal State LA as well. And it's been powerful, right? It's been powerful. I have won research presentations. I published my thesis, and I've developed such powerful connections with the community, with professors, with my colleagues, and it's been powerful. But it all started at East LA College. And that's one of the things that I wanted to share, because I've met others, right, that are struggling, that, again, we're first generation. We don't know the resources. Like, for example, right, I didn't want to apply for financial aid because it was super intimidating. I felt like my mom was making okay money, so I wouldn't qualify, right? And thinking back, I'm like, man, like, you're 18, and to you, $20,000, $25,000, that's a lot of money. But little did I know that I qualified for everything and more, right, and work study. And so going through that journey of actually working at the financial aid office as a student worker, getting the grants, getting the support, getting this strong, strong presence of people that didn't actually just give you lip service, but they worked and they directed you and they made sure you were equipped. It was powerful. And that's why to this day, one of my biggest dreams is to teach at East LA College, because East LA College to me, it doesn't just represent, ooh, I'm getting emotional. It doesn't just represent a community college, but it is a network. It is a jewel in our community. It is made up of people that give a damn about our people, give a damn about our community. And to this day, I speak at ELAC. I finished my internship at ELAC. I am so grateful that I was able to work at East LA College as an intern for a community college history course. And it was beautiful, and this was in 2018. So being there, being at East LA College, I was at the Southgate campus, and then there's the main campuses at Monterey Park. But being there, it felt so beautiful to see so many young people, older people, working people, you know, single parents, doing something about their situation and believing in themselves. When I recognize that a lot of times we don't have that equipment, we don't have those tools, right? We didn't come from a privileged backgrounds. And so, and especially predominantly Mexican, Central American, and Black, it was beautiful, right? And so I'm wearing this sweater today because I am proud to be from East LA College. East LA College saved my life. And I believe in the power of transformation and education. I believe in the power of our community, of ourselves. And I wanted to share this testimony with people because I haven't seen much about this, right? About first generation, about what it is that you get. And to me, it's not about just education. It's not just about a degree. But to me, at that time in my life, East LA College, the people that I met at East LA College were the keys for my success. They were the keys for me to obtain mental health that I needed. It was the key for me to obtain, you know, financial stability. Going from sleeping in a car to affording my own apartment, going from, you know, working three jobs, you know, working up at 4 a.m. to being able to get a successful job within a year of working at East LA College. So all of these things I don't take for granted, and I know the power and I know the potential that so many of us have. And, you know, college isn't for everybody. I understand that. Some people don't care for college. They don't want to go. My respects. I'm not here to convince people. But what I'm here to tell you is that in my life, the way that I was going, you know, East LA College really allowed me to fulfill myself, for me to believe in myself and add value to who I am and was becoming, because you never stop becoming, right? And at this point, I am a graduate student with my master's in history. I've held highest honors. I published my thesis on Amazon. I have a self-published poetry book that's been used at different colleges throughout the United States. And I'm loving it. I'm loving the experiences. I love seeing young people, you know, get there and fight for themselves and advocate for themselves, because all in all, at the end of the day, we have to advocate for ourselves. We have to advocate for our community. And like I said, to this day, I still go to ELAC. I am there. I try to help with projects. I speak to students. I am passionate about not just education and community college, but to me, I know that there's someone out there that's also going through the same things. Maybe they're not openly talking about it like I wasn't, but the resources are there and they're free and they're accessible and they belong to us, and that's why they are placed there. So I want to give a shout out to East LA College, to all of my professors that supported me, that believed in me when I didn't. That's where I started, and I'm never, ever going to be ashamed of being from East LA College. I love ELAC. Like I said, my dream is to be a history or Chicano studies professor at East LA College or at a community college. To me, it saves lives, and it saves lives like myself. It saved my life. And to this day and everywhere I go, that's why I know the power of education. I know the power of people's support and them offering you the resources that you didn't think you deserved because of where we come from, because of the lack of resources that we come from, the backgrounds that we come from. As a first generation college student, I've been very successful and I have busted my ass on my academics and my studies, and anyone can attest to that. But again, it all started at ELAC, and I will forever, forever be grateful. If you have any questions about ELAC, please message me. I'm always trying to stay in contact. Like I said, I was an intern there in 2019. I'm in the process. My dream is to teach at East LA College. For all of you first generation college students, I wish you the best. Do not stop fighting for yourself. You deserve it. You deserve the opportunity. You deserve that scholarship. You deserve that grant. And you deserve the experience of receiving the best services to you, the best services and quality of education, because you deserve it and we need it and they belong to us. So East LA College, this is my little testimony. Just wanted to share. I love ELAC. Proud alumni of ELAC class of 2013. What's up?